So what I want to talk about is, I want to talk first about Egypt. We have seen a number of things happen in the last few weeks, and I want to give some information and where Egypt is going to go from here on. First of all, we have 80 million people living there, and most of Egypt is desert. And so the people are living in a very confined area. Egypt has never been a free nation. It began as a kingdom 3,150 years before Christ. So Egypt as a nation is more than 5,000 years old. One of the oldest kingdoms on the earth. And they have always been ruled by a king or a pharaoh. Around 1650 before Christ, there was an empire which is in Turkey today called the Hittite Empire. And the Hittites moved around and they conquered Egypt and held that for about 500 years. It was a Hittite pharaoh that was there when Joseph came to Egypt. And when Moses left, the Egyptians had driven out the Hittites and taken their nation back, but still it was a pharaoh or a king that ruled it. In 343 BC, Greece came, Alexander the Great conquered Egypt, and the Greeks held Egypt for about 200-300 years, and then came the Romans. And the Romans held Egypt to approximately 700 AD when the Islamic forces invaded Egypt and took it over. Here's a very interesting thing to point out. After Jesus had been resurrected, the apostles went into Egypt. And approximately 150 AD, most of people in Egypt were Christians. And they developed a church called the Coptic Church. And the Coptic Church was never under the Roman church. Now, when the Muslims came in, they wiped out of all Christianity. Tunisia was a Christian nation. Algeria, Morocco, the entire North Africa was Christian until Islam came in and ruled by the sword. Once Egypt had been occupied by Islam, with Islamic forces, it was then ruled by the Ottoman Empire, which was Turkey. And Turkey ruled that until World War I, where the British took it away. Here's a very interesting thing as I give just a historical background. In 1798, Napoleon Bonaparte, the French emperor, invaded Egypt and held it for about 2 years. And then he was driven out. When the Suez Canal was built, it was financed by the Rothschilds. And the Rothschilds owned and operated that canal for a number of years. From 1805 to 1952, Egypt was ruled by kings, dictators. And from World War I and up to 1953, Egypt was actually under British rule. And the last king to rule down it was King Farouk. And he was thrown out in 1953. He was a bad playboy, into pornography, women, booze, whatever you had it. He was a horrible guy. And then from 1953, we have had three dictators. Nasser took power in 56. Sadat in 1970, and Hosni Mubarak in 1981. Think about this now. Here's a nation more than 5,000 years old that had always been ruled by dictators. In the Middle East, of every nation, we have demonic rulers or archons. These are princes. And the prince of Egypt has been over Egypt for 5,000 years. The question now is, why has the archon over Egypt, satanic, loosed his grip? Because never before in the history of Egypt has a people made an uprising, not with weapons, but simply coming out on the streets. What's behind us? I can tell you this, it is not the world government. They are horrified. I believe that as we are coming into the end times, that Jesus said that the gospel shall be preached to all nations. And I believe that God simply has opened up Egypt at this time where he wants to have the gospel presented to these people that over the years have been slaves. You got to understand now that the rulers in the Middle East are cruel. You take the Syrians, the Jordanians, in Yemen, Iraq, Iran, they have torture, killing. I mean, these rulers are wicked, have been like that for thousands of years. And some of the people have broken free. What's going to happen now? What is happening behind the scenes? Well, this year, the United States has earmarked $1.3 billion for the Egyptian military. Almost every officer from lieutenant and up in the Egyptian Army, in the Air Force, and Navy have been trained in the United States. They speak good English, and they are pro-Western. Egypt's weapons are American weapons. And when you buy weapons from a country, you got to remember this, spare parts. And so when we sell weapons, tanks, airplanes, and so on, we have a chokehold on these nations because if they don't behave right, we simply cut off the spare parts and the supplies. The Soviet Union operated exactly the same way, and so has every other nation. Thus, in the Egyptian military, we have a number of officers that I would say are working for the CIA. Because when we have military coming over here, the CIA recruits a number of people and put them back in what they call a sleeper position. Iran has a tremendous strong intelligence operation. And Iran has a number of agents in Egypt, and Iran is hoping to capture that through the Muslim Brotherhood. Then we have Israel. Now, Egypt has a large Jewish population. They have been there for 3,000 years or plus. And so the Israeli Mossad has a lot of agents in Egypt. France has agents in Egypt. England has agents in Egypt. Thus, that country is simply permeated by intelligence agents, including Russia, that has some there too. It's going to be a battle now over, are they really going to get a democracy? Are they going to be able to elect their own leaders? I believe that we need to pray that God will simply hold the door open. Eventually, Egypt will go under the world government. But right now, it is open. It is similar to what it was in Czechoslovakia in 1956 when they tried to break loose and for a few weeks they threw off the Soviet, then the Soviet came back in. So we're living in exciting times, and we need to understand that the people of Egypt, for the first time in 5,000 years, have a chance to be free. Notice, they cleaned up the square and the streets afterwards. There was no violence. I believe that God's Spirit has been working there. Let me talk now what we can do ourselves. I want to thank, first of all of you that have given to us this month. And I thank you for that. I thank you for those of you that are watching us right now, that we continue to give and keep this ministry going. We are very shortly going to release the next little booklet called The Rothschilds. And it's going to be a very powerful instrument in revealing what the world government is doing. Let me tell you about Christian Dynamics number one. And this is what I want to talk to all our friends that are watching us and those of you that are here. Christian Dynamics number one is printed, collated, proofread, ready. We have hundreds of stacks ready to go. We are now at the phase that we need to have covers. I cannot print in color. We have to farm that out. And so in order to finish Christian Dynamics number one, we need $2,000. That's for the printing, the covers, the technicians are going to help us to show us how to bind it and so on. We have all the machinery. And I'm going to ask you that are watching us, would you be willing? I know you've given this month, but would you be willing to simply say, I'm going to invest in Christian Dynamics? It's the most powerful book we ever produced. And help us out so that we can proceed. I got the printer lined up. He's a Christian. I got the cover design. I got everything except cash. So I thank you very much if you can give us a hand and help us out.